Well, hello there, my YouTube gang. What's up? It's Joniversity again, and this is going to be the first in a series of videos regarding Iran and its nuclear program. Now, there are several issues that we need to address when we speak about this whole nuclear Iran thing. The first, of course, is Iran actually after the bomb? Or maybe it's not, because if it's not, then there's nothing that we need to do about it. Then, of course, you have other questions like, what might Iran do? What can Iran do? What might it want to do and to achieve? How we can contain Iran or deter Iran or maybe even use force? And finally, you need to answer, what are the possible outcomes for each answer? Now, this video is actually, I think, one of the most important ones, because this is actually the central issue. Is Iran after a nuclear bomb or not? And I'm going to present my case, which I think is quite solid, and I'm going to base it on four things. First of all, an Iranian peaceful nuclear program for energy doesn't make any economic sense. The second is that there's too much deception regarding this whole thing. The third is based on intelligence reports. And the fourth is based on our favorite, science. So let's begin with the economic sense of a peaceful nuclear program for Iran. Now think of this, okay? For Iran to develop a peaceful nuclear program for energy purposes, it needs, first of all, to actually finance the research program. Then you have to build and maintain reactors and enrichment plants. And add to that the toll of the sanctions that are brought upon Iran because of its nuclear program. So when you put all these together and then you try to equate them to just build oil refineries and natural gas related infrastructure in a country that has the second biggest natural gas resources in the world and the fifth biggest oil resources in the world. So building all these facilities and maintaining them without any toll from sanctions would be, in Iran's case, the most sensible thing to do, especially if you take into account its natural gas and oil resources. But the thing is that even enrichment itself doesn't make any economic sense, because you see, all the compromises that the West tried to reach with Iran spoke of certain countries providing Iran with uranium already enriched to reactor-grade fuel. And even today, their only operational reactor is actually fueled by Russia. So why the hell would you even want to enrich your own uranium and take all that heat? Now, the second issue is deception. Already in 2003, the IAEA reported that Iran has systematically failed to meet its obligations under its NPT safeguard agreement to report nuclear activities. And in Dr. Amano's first report as the head of the IAEA, he actually said, and I quote, "On the basis of extensive and credible information, the IAEA now has concerns about the possible existence in Iran of undisclosed activities related to the development of a nuclear payload for a missile, and concerns about possible military dimensions to Iran's nuclear program." Now, a very similar report was repeated this March, again by Dr. Amano, and here's what he said.
"The agency continues, under its comprehensive safeguards agreement with Iran, to verify the non-diversion of declared nuclear materials in Iran, but we cannot confirm that all nuclear material in Iran is in peaceful activities because Iran has not provided the agency with the necessary cooperation. The necessary cooperation includes, among other things, implementation of relevant resolutions of the IAEA Board of Governors and the United Nations Security Council, implementation of the additional protocol and of modified Code 3.1, as well as some clarification of issues related to possible military dimensions to Iran's nuclear program. I request Iran to take steps towards the full implementation of its safeguards agreement and its other obligations as a matter of high priority.
So the question just begs to be asked. If Iran has signed all the treaties and allowed inspectors in, then why the fuck should they hide anything from them? Heck, why hide an entire nuclear facility like the one uncovered in Qum in 2009, which was hidden inside a fucking mountain? Or, you know what, about the centrifuge complex revealed by the Iranian opposition group, the MEK? So what we basically just need to ask ourselves is, why would you use any sort of deception if all you want to do is develop nuclear energy for peaceful means? Now, the third issue I want to touch upon is the one regarding reports by intelligence agencies. A report usually brought by the supporters of the Islamic Republic of Iran is a report by the NIE in 2007, which, according to Iran's supporters, allegedly cleared Iran from all suspicions and allegations of pursuing nuclear weapons. Well, here's what it really said, and I quote, "We assess with moderate confidence Tehran had not restarted its nuclear weapons program, but we do know whether it currently intends to develop nuclear weapons." Now remember that only 4 years earlier, the same NIE concluded in 2003 that, with high confidence, Iran currently is determined to develop nuclear weapons despite its international obligations and international pressure. And I think we can all guess why Iran suddenly decided to stop its weapons program in 2003. You remember what happened that year? Most damning of all evidence is a laptop stolen by a German intelligence officer in 2004, and on its hard drive were thousands of pages, documents, drawings, and even multimedia slides, including a report on 18 attempts to alter the size, the weight, and the diameter of the nose cone of the Shahab 3 missile to fit it with what was dubbed a new payload. And as if that's not enough, on that same laptop, they also found designs of how to conduct a nuclear experiment, which detailed a 6-mile-long and a 1/4-mile-deep tunnel for an atomic explosion test. Now, there are many other resources and examples that I could have given you for the first three issues that I dealt with, but I want to dig in on the fourth one, which is the scientific issue. And here I think you really get a clear picture on what Iran's intentions are. Okay, so let's go with some basics. First of all, there are two links to two videos that I've already posted in the past in the description box. And I really suggest you go and watch them. They give a rather full view and information about this whole nuclear thing. But if I was to sum it up, I would go with the following bullet points. First, we have two types of fissile material used for nuclear purposes. One is uranium-235, and the other is plutonium-239. Now, there are a few ways to produce plutonium, and the easiest of all is actually to extract it from used nuclear fuel, and that is because one of the byproducts of fission of uranium-235 is actually plutonium. Uranium-235, on the other hand, is actually extracted from natural uranium, which is mined from Earth. And using different means, usually gas centrifuges, which is considered the most efficient, the uranium-235 is separated and clustered. So, and this is what we call enriching uranium, because you enrich the level of uranium-235 within the uranium itself. And we know today that Iran is building its own centrifuges by the thousands. and they are actually also in the process of developing their own uranium mines. And what they've also managed to do is to convert the uranium ore, what is commonly referred to as yellow cake, into uranium hexafluoride gas, which is used in gas centrifuges in order to enrich uranium further. And now let's quickly go back into this whole enriching uranium thing. Okay, so in natural uranium, the amount of uranium-235 is only slightly more than 0.7%. In order to reach a reactor-grade fuel, you'll have to enrich the uranium to a level of 3%, which means that you have to have at least 3% of uranium-235 inside your fissile material. Now, if you enrich uranium up to 20%, then this level of enrichment is sufficient to create a crude, inefficient bomb, which will take about 120 kilograms of uranium to reach critical mass. And the enrichment level, which we call highly enriched uranium, which is weapons grade, is somewhere around 80 and 90%. And when you have uranium enriched to that degree, you would need around 20 to 25 kilograms of enriched uranium to produce a nuclear device. Now, the first scientific issue that we have with Iran's nuclear program is the sheer number of centrifuges that Iran has and produces. And the thing is that if you want to enrich uranium only to a reactor grade level, which is 3%, or low enriched uranium, requires a small amount of centrifuges. Of course, it depends on how many reactors you're going to have. Now, already in 2009, in a paper by the Program on Science and Global Security in Princeton University, noted that the sheer number and capabilities of Iran's centrifuges array surpass by far the amount needed for a continuous flow of nuclear fuel. And lastly, what I really think makes this case rather clear-cut, Iran has yet to agree to convert its 3.5 tons of LEU hexafluoride into uranium oxide. Now, uranium oxide can be used for nuclear fuel for reactors, but it cannot be further enriched, meaning that once they have reached low enriched uranium of 3%, which they say they want only to fuel their peaceful nuclear program, if they would have converted their stockpile into uranium oxide instead of what they have now, which is uranium hexafluoride, then we would all be at peace now because we wouldn't have to worry about Iran putting that extra uranium back into the centrifuges and further enriching the uranium until it reaches the weapons grade. Okay, so this is basically the first video, and this is just to answer the question, is Iran after a nuclear weapon or not? And in the second video I'm going to do on this matter, which I have no idea when it's going to happen, I hope it's going to happen soon, I'm going to try to address the current and the future state of Iran's nuclear program and what we can and should do about it. So, I hope I didn't bore you too much. And like always, my beloved YouTube gang, peace, love, harmony, have a good one. And people of Iran, everyone in the West is with you, believe me. Okay, bye-bye.